Yo guys, what is up? It's Teach here, coming at you again with another video, and we are over on Aberration to show you something that I thought a lot more people know, but they don't actually. So this is called the Beer Run, and it's probably one of the most overpowered ways to destroy any turret in Ark. Now all you need, flak, beer, and that's, you know, pretty much the main thing that you need out of all of this. However, you can kind of do it in a bunch of different ways, so it's up to you how you do it. The best way to do it, just get some primitive flak. If you're going up against the big base, you're probably gonna need better than primitive flak, but you know, it's entirely up to you. You're gonna need a beer jar, which usually you want to place in your hotbar in some way, shape, or form. You probably want to have a mind wipe tonic. I usually bring an organic polymer, you'll see why in a second here, and then this is another thing you can bring if you plan on getting out. So basically what we're looking for here is you want a C4 and some form, or I guess it doesn't necessarily matter if it's a C4, you want some form of explosive. Now, in order to blow up any turret in Ark, it's actually very simple. You just need a little bit of knowledge on how to do so. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you first how to actually destroy these turrets. I've got a bunch of setup here, how to do auto regular turrets. We've got over there in the middle, that's heavy turrets, and then over there on the side is tech turrets. Now, right here, you can see this guy is pretty simple. This is a just regular automated turret. There's nothing special about it. If I put a C4 down on it, it goes boom because it does 27,000 damage. Now, C4 will instantly destroy heavies and autos. Pretty simple, actually. Now, all you gotta do is, you know, do that right there. So when they're firing at you, it gets a little bit more difficult, however, because they will shred your armor pretty quick and you have big problems. For example, this right here, you can see that he is shooting my armor, does damage, and if I look at the actual overall everything here, it almost totally shredded my flak pants and it almost totally shredded my chest piece. Now, what you want to be careful about is when this does get shredded, it starts doing direct damage to yourself. So how do you avoid that? Now, the answer is pretty simple. You use beer. Now, beer, what it does is it greatly reduces the amount of damage that is incoming to your character. Now, you could literally run any just auto turret completely naked with just beer. Now, the reason is beer heavily, I can't describe this enough, heavily reduces the amount of damage you take. So I am naked. Normally, I would get smoked by a turret like this. But if you drink a little bit of beer before you go, you can run up close to this turret and get within a range to kill it. Now, you saw that 46 damage per shot. That is pretty standard across the board. It takes heavily reduced amount of damage. So 46 and then heavy turrets would do more, and then obviously the tech turrets would do more damage as well. So you want to try and bring your flak armor the further you have to go, and I'll go ahead and show you with this right here how to properly run that one right there. Let's go ahead and get this and put all this guy on. Now that we've got some flak armor, we're gonna get another beer canister. We're gonna get a C4 charge. We're gonna load it ahead of time, just like this right here, and you're gonna drop it, and it doesn't matter if you blow yourself up because you're gonna be using the beds nearby. So now we'll go ahead and show you. Boom, we pop that beer. See how reduced that damage is? And then boom, we blow that right there. Now you can see that we took some pretty heavy damage on our flak kit, and then the beer itself is slowly draining our stamina. So what you want to do, just like I did right there, if you're going to do another beer run, you want to make sure you get a reset of everything. So you're going to want to go back to your beds, reset everything, because if you do not, the beer will eventually make your stamina drop to zero. Now dropping to zero, and it's going to hold it at zero while you recover from the literal hangover that it gives you. And then once you do that, you are pretty set in stone and solid, good to go. So you're going to notice right here, you want to make sure you have every piece of that flak. If you don't have every piece of flak, you're going to have a big problem when trying to get to those turrets. You can grab a couple of stimulant. If you wanted to do this the proper way, what you want to do is bring one of each of these things I have in my hotbar right here. Now, the reason you bring them, I'll describe that in a second right here. So you have the beer, obviously, to take the reduced damage. You have the mind wipe tonic, because when you consume it, you want to jack your health way, 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 way up, as high as you possibly can take it, because you want to be able to just absolutely blast through whatever you need to. A little bit of stamina is never a bad idea, and then move speed can be really useful for the other parts of it, because you want to be able to get to the turrets as quick as possible. Usually I literally split it between that health and that right there. I'm going to go ahead and get that health back so I don't have to make you guys wait. You can see 500 health, 176 move speed. Now, what we're going to do is there are four turrets. This is prim armor. This is just regular turrets. Now, what we're going to do is we're just going to sprint straight at them. You can see they're going to start firing right around there. You want to try and reduce the amount of damage you possibly take from them by trying to like cut off as many angles as possible. So I'm going to go at it from this angle and run and sprint at it. You have the organic polymer, just in case you need to use it. Obviously, it's an insta-kill on a character. And then you have a little bit of a stamina potion for these number 5 stimulants to actually gain some stamina back for you over time. And all of this is used in combination with this C4 charge in order to blow up all those turrets. So we're going to take one beer. I'm going to go ahead and show you how easy this is. Oh, I didn't quite get there. So you literally just run at it and blow it up. Now, you notice that I did it from a distance, so what you want to be able to do is try and cut off corners in this situation or have something block for you. Usually, you're probably not raiding a load, or you probably have better armor than the, you know, standard crappy armor that I've got right here. So you don't need to worry about these, how do I say this properly? This damage destroying your flak before you get to them. But if you're trying to just use primitive flak, it's actually pretty simple. Again, we're just going to grab one of these and I'll show you how to do it, because we're just going to try and reduce the amount of damage we take. So now, basically, this is the perfect turret setup, because you can't just flak run it right here. You see that I got close and it caused issues. So what we're going to do is we're going to pretend that, you know, let's say I go in from this side right here. So when we're running at these things, we want to try and reduce the amount of damage. Now, if you have a tame, see how it's already shooting me, but the other three aren't, even though I can see it. If you have a tame, you want to try and get that tame as close to those as possible, like a large tame, like a Brontosaurus, to block the turret is amazing. And then you run up with this C4 and you go for it. However, let's say you don't have something like that. You are going to need some better overall flak in order to actually run this thing. If you do not have better overall flak, you're going to have a big problem. So how do you solve this issue? One, make better flak. Two, let's just force tame a, I don't know, this guy right here. And force tame. Thank you. And you want to block the turrets with this guy and then run up to them. Now, he's not obviously going to fit at all into this, so this might be problematic, but you get the point. You want to try and use a body or something to block this for you in order to actually run a turret wall. Now, I'm going to pretend that I've got a body block like right about here. I'm just going to destroy this wall right here so you can see how much easier it is. And right there. So now we're going to get rid of our GCM rifle. And I'm going to jump in from this side, take my beer, and actually go in and take out everything in here. So we've basically pretended like we've got our little Paraceratherium right here, so we're nice and close, blocking these guys, so we are just close to the run. Now all we're going to do is run as close as possible, drop our C4, and blow it up. Now, you can see that I took a ton of damage. However, my flak, as you can see, totally gone. That beer jar basically prevents you from taking further damage and totally getting shredded. So that beer run right here actually shreds these four turrets. Now, four turrets, as long as you can get decently close, you can see that I destroyed my armor and everything. But you can actually run a turret without having to soak it, without having to do any of the difficult stuff. So again, now the next thing that you want to do, grab some of that right there, and then you've got yourself a literal new body to go back to. Now you can go back and shred all your armor and get that stuff back if you want to. It's entirely up to you. Now, the best way to use a beer run is when someone has improperly placed turrets. Now we're going to go ahead and show you how to do this on heavy turrets next. We're going to go ahead and grab one of each of the armor pieces that we need. Again, this is just primitive flak. If you had better flak, this makes it like you can soak entire walls with this kind of stuff, which is crazy, crazy. So we're going to go ahead, show you how to do this guy. Now we're going to do the exact same thing over here. We're going to blow up a turret. We want to grab a organic polymer because we're going to know we're going to be successful. And we're going to go in here. So this is a great example. A lot of people will put turrets behind walls and stuff like that right here. So you can literally go into this thing, run up really quickly, even to heavies, tech turrets even, and blow them up. Now, you're probably going to have to use a bunch of bodies in order to get this, but sometimes it works pretty well. So we're going to take this guy to reduce the amount of damage we take. You'll see we're in here. And then we went ahead and did some damage to it. Notice how we got that 787, but we missed the actual turret, which kind of sucks. Sometimes that happens because in third-person mode, it's going to throw it wherever it feels like throwing it, which is really, really stupid. But basically, you saw that we took reduced damage. That's the point of the spear run, to take enough reduced damage where you can get close enough to turrets to actually destroy them. Now, you can do, we're going to do this one more time, and I'll show you how to do it with non-third-person mode on, which is usually what I would do, because for some reason third-person mode attaches it to a faraway wall, and that's kind of just how it is, but oh well, there are worse things. So we've got everything we need, C4, there we go, number 6, grab our beer, take the beer, go into first-person mode, and drop this bad boy right there. And notice that 27,000 damage gets done. See ya, turret. So, now, when you properly do it like this, you're basically trying to cut off the maximum amount of length that you can take here. So, if we were running 10 foundations away, yes, with primitive armor, this heavy turret is going to destroy us. If we had journeyman or mastercraft armor, however, we probably would have been fine. But because we only have prim in this example, we only want to use a short distance to actually destroy these turrets. But that beer saves your life because you can get up nice and close to turrets and do as much damage as possible. Now, another thing that people forget that you can do is you can do something called rocket running. Now, rocket running is another one of those things that is highly useful. It is a little bit better than C4 in certain situations. It kind of depends on what you're doing and how you're going about it. But what you do with a rocket run is you grab literally a rocket and then you run it at turrets. Now, rocket running, again, pretty simple. Nothing super classy about it. You literally just load a rocket in ahead of time, grab your beer, run down the long hallway, and fire it at that thing. Now, this is useful literally when you are running at turrets and you know you can't get all the way to them. So, you go ahead and grab your beer, you get as close as you think you can, and you shoot that turret or that rocket off. Now, I wasn't close enough right there. But what you can do is you can repeat that process over and over and block with other stuff, all this stuff, and get nice and close so you're actually doing damage to the turrets. Now, obviously, we don't have anything to block for us right now, but if we did, you could put a blocker in front of it and blow that turret up. Now, that is a very popular way to do it. So, you know, everyone, at this point, everyone uses the rocket run, uses the C4 runs, all kinds of beer runs, whatever you want to call it. But there is only one thing that can really counter a beer run. Now, that is the tech turret. Now, the tech turret is a major pain in the butt because it only takes damage from certain sources. Now, the sources that a tech turret takes damage from? Yeah, pain in the butt, tech in general. That is pretty much the only thing you can use to successfully destroy tech turrets. Now, I have one over here just so you can see. If I was to put down a C4 on the ground right there, I'll go ahead and show you how much damage it does. Not enough is the answer. It does not do enough damage. So we did some damage there and it only did 750-ish damage. Not enough. So what you need to do, ooh, just like you saw right there, why this thing is destroyed by it. If you try and rocket run a beer barrel in any way, shape, or form, you're gonna get destroyed. So you have to, quite literally, watch. So, if I'm sitting here in normal GCM, this little splash effect is going to knock you back. So what you do is you take a tech weapon of some kind in order to destroy it. Now, tech grenades are really good against it because you can see it did 1,000 damage. Now, if you can get it up nice and close, tech turrets do not shoot anything. So, they will get absolutely shredded by rockets, by tech grenades, whatever you want to use. I like using tech grenades because they do a ton of damage to tech structures, but that's my personal opinion on that. But if you rocket run or beer run or use these tech grenades for tech turrets, it is a great thing to use. They're super cheap to make, actually. And you can see that right up here, here's our body right here. We're going to go and grab everything off of him, pretend like we had our rocket run. If I was right about here and fired my rocket, you're going to notice how one rocket did almost a full destructo bot of damage on this thing. However, if I was to go further away and I throw a grenade, it's going to get shot out of the sky. But if I'm close enough to it, it'll shred the actual turret. So your beer runs are literally only used in order to get you close enough to a turret to destroy it. Now, there's a lot of different ways to do it. I've shown you beer running with just C4, with rockets, with grenades. As long as you're using beer, you if you aren't, first off, you need to because it makes raiding so much easier and defending so much easier when someone's got just one or two turrets placed down. You pop some of those beer jars and you're good to go. So, anyways, hope for this video helps you out. And other than that, teach.